3.1, practice and research. Now, when I had my feedback from my tutor to do with the initial plan, it was agreed that for me to make alterations to the plan, which was to introduce the theme of dyslexia, we both considered that I need to research the area a little bit deeper in order to make the plan a little bit more structured and a little bit more explaining what my aims are going to be with my practice and research. So, as you could see, the work that I'd put together, which can be viewed on my blog, she put forward some suggestions, and the area that I'm going into for my practice is going to be mixed media. So on her suggestions, I started to look at John Walter and looked at his exhibition work called Capsid. Now, this was quite interesting because capsid is a protective outer layer for viruses. Now, I'd covered a little bit of antibacteria as a theme in my contemporary practice. So this is an area that I'm semi-familiar with, but would like to research a little bit deeper. But again, just to get to know this artist, I want to build up some informative information. So I've been using, again, the skill of mind mapping initial notes, as we can see, printing off some detailed work of the artist. And then I've started to sketch in some of my own drawings. And I just pulled out from previous assignments where, as we can see, some of my own work of stitching and mark making that kind of reminded me of bacteria. Again, I want to keep everything very visual. I feel that this is my understanding in my assignment work. So I've printed off some detailed stuff. I do use a lot of photography in my research and so forth. So again, I've started to look at exhibitions of John Walter. And it is bizarre that when you do start to look at your own pieces of work, this in particular I've pulled out from Ideas and Processes, not necessarily because I want to use old samples, but this with bleach and inks kind of replicates cells. So I'm going to pop that to one side and use this as a piece of, you know, collected information that I might use at a later date. Some of the drawings that I used actually for my contemporary practice essay, I did actually build up a mind map of ideas on bacteria and growing bacteria in fabric. And then, as we can see up here, as mentioned previously, I'd started to delve into COVID, actually. It was the early stages of COVID-19, and I'd created some masks with using expandable foam and neon colours as a colour palette. And then also as well from Vocabulary Textiles, some stitch work that I'd put together. I do feel that now bringing some old work in is going to be relevant to my research. But I think also as well it opens up and expands new areas and some initial ideas that I can, you know, go back, rework and push the boundaries with the work. I think it's been really important for me to make documentations and so forth of the videos that I watched of John Walter. Those were really, really interesting, and how he brings together his ideas and his practices with his themes. Also as well, all of this research is going to be referenced in my Harvard Generator. So I'm already starting at this stage to bring together my critical strategies alongside with my creative strategies. It's going to be a long process. There are lots of areas to still cover, but I kind of think it's going to start opening doorways and so forth. At this stage, I am really enjoying the work, and by using older samples and bringing together some new samples, I think it's just been responsive to the new learning with the research. So I don't really feel that I'm at the point where I do want to start to go off in one direction and start to sort and select and refine anything at this stage. I just want the textile samples that I'm going to produce just to be a response and maybe come back to them as ideas.